What is up, beautiful people? It's your girl, Nicole Young, and I am back with another video. In today's video, I am going to be going over a topic that was requested. I want to say shout out to Kalpani, who requested this video. I think it's a great topic. So in this video, I'm going to be talking about what I am learning specifically right now as I teach myself code, and going to go into some specific resources that I have been using that have been really helpful in helping me make progress. I'm also going to give you a short formula that I have been using to help me make real progress as I'm learning, and just kind of the steps that I take for finding resources that will work for me. Before I jump into this video, I wanted to say that I am currently taking on the 100 Days of Code Challenge on Instagram. If you are interested in joining me on the 100 Days of Code, and if you are interested in joining a private Facebook group that I started with some of my friends and followers who are also taking the challenge, make sure that you go onto Instagram, hit the follow button, and DM me so that I can send you the link for that private Facebook group. Okay, so here is my formula for finding things that work for me. The first thing that I know I need to do when I'm just getting started is to find a book or an online course or class to learn the basics. So I will go over the online courses that I have used in the past in just a moment. But for Swift, this is the book that I have been using to learn. It's for beginners, but it also uses project-based learning to teach you the basics of Swift. So each chapter is a small project that you will complete, usually an app or something like that, and there's 12 of them. So my goal is to do one a week for 12 weeks while I'm doing 100 Days of Code. I haven't actually finished the first one that I started yet, so I'm a little behind, but I'll get it together. Here is this. I will leave the link, Greg Lim, I will leave the link down below in the description so that if you are interested in learning Swift, you can check it out, because I definitely think this one is a really great resource. The next thing that I do once I get some basics under my belt is I then try to branch out and get curious, and I use Google to just search projects within that language. I have also already been thinking about things that I need in my personal life and tools that I want to build once I get to a certain point. And that has been helpful too, because I know specifically the things that I need to learn to be able to build the productivity apps that I want to build for myself and things like that. So I know what skills I need to learn, and if they don't come up in this book, I will know what I will need to Google or what I will need to try to search on online classes to pick up so that I can build those things next. Okay, so now I am going to show you what I have been using online. So let's get started with that. Hey guys. Okay, so I'm going to quickly go over some things that I've used so far that I really have liked. So a lot of online boot camps and online schools that are geared towards teaching you coding or something in that realm, there are a good number of them that have what is called pre-coursework. And it's basically the coursework that you have to complete before you get admitted into their programs. So for me, I was very confused as to like what direction I wanted to take things when I started to say like decide that I wanted to take coding seriously. I thought that I probably needed to take on some type of boot camp or online class because I just felt like that might be a little easier on me. And I had a friend that was already in the iOS course for Lambda School and like had just rave reviews about it. So I checked it out, and the pre-coursework was amazing. So I learned so many things, and I'll show you kind of like what each little section looks like. And so it would have just a video here, and the videos ranged from anywhere from like 3 minutes to 20 minutes. And you would just watch this lecture, and it would be literally someone with like on Xcode doing whatever the problems were. And you were just supposed to be on Xcode following along. And there were also areas where like
you would download problems based around whatever the section was, and then you would complete the problems and upload them on here too. And it was really helpful. I learned so much. I learned about the ways that Swift works, and this is how I got introduced to Swift. So another thing was Team Treehouse. I looked up the pricing on Team Treehouse, and it is super expensive, but I did not have to pay for it. It was something that was made available to me through my last tech job, and I still have access to it, kind of. So with Team Treehouse, I really liked it, actually. I'll do an actual review video on it and go a little deeper into it, but they would have a video explaining some concept, and then between every couple of videos, you would also have problems that you had to solve as you went along. And they have a pretty robust community where you can get all your questions answered and that kind of thing. I liked it, and I still reference it here and there. This is Skill Crush. And again, I think I'll probably make videos reviewing each of these separate resources and online courses that I've done that are paid ones, because I understand that, like, when you're being self-taught, it can be very easy to start paying for online resources and end up spending way too much. So I don't mind doing like reviews on these, on ones that I've liked and didn't like. So this is one of the classes that I paid for Skill Crush. I have not obviously started it yet, so I will let you guys know. But here is one that I have done. So this was an HTML and CSS course. It was like very basics. And I really liked this because not only did it teach the basics of HTML and CSS, it gave it to you in a way that where you had a portfolio of things by the end of the course. So like, I was able to build my own personal website. I was able to contribute to a website like that they have for some of their learners that are learning HTML. I was able to create some really cool projects with this, and I completely like was able to nail it in the HTML and CSS things. So Skill Crush was, you know, really helpful for this, and I will let you guys know how it was for Python. I'm just interested to seeing how they approach teaching Python, because Python is a little bit more of an involved language than HTML and CSS. So I will definitely do a review when I finish that. That will be something that you guys can look forward to. All right, so that's pretty much it for the online resource that I'm using right now. I will have a video that comes out. I will definitely post a video on just in general all of the free resources that I've come across in my time learning, and ones that I think are useful, ones that I think that you should definitely check out. So keep an eye out for that video as well. That is all I have for you guys. I love you, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.